Hi everybody, I'm back again with another video on this channel. I know it's been a bit scarce for videos on this channel just lately. That's mainly because I've been doing some videos for my other channel, which is a board game channel. Now that I've caught up with that, I'm going to concentrate a little bit more on this channel. And the first video up for viewing is all four Hot Toys Black Widow figures that have been released to date. Now the reason I'm doing this video, I want to show the differences between all three, all four. There's people out there who probably haven't got this figure, who are thinking about getting a Black Widow figure. It's an expensive hobby, so you probably won't want to get all four. And they're thinking, well, which one should I go for? So hopefully this video will enlighten you and give you that, well, help you make that decision on which one to go for. So as you can see, we have all four that have been released. This one over here was from Iron Man 2. Here we have the Avengers Assemble version, the Winter Soldier version, and the Age of Ultron version. Just by looking at all four together, you can probably tell that this one is a lot taller than the other three. This one just looks tall because it's on a taller base, but these three are roughly the same size. This one is too tall for Scarlet. The proportions are all wrong. The breasts are a little bit too big. Her backside sticks out a little bit too much. You'll see that when I put the figures side by side. Side profile, should I say, which I'll do in a little while. None of them, in my opinion, resemble Scarlet perfectly, facial wise. One is better than the others, and I'll come to that when we move on to the head sculpts. They've all got rooted hair. Now there is an issue that a lot of 1/6 scale figure collectors have got with rooted hair. You have to style it yourself, and if like me you're no good at that, you might use the wrong products, it might affect the paintwork or melt the plastic on the face or the suit or whatever. I steer clear of that. So as you see them here, this is how they came out of the box. Probably the better one of the four is the Winter Soldier version. To me, that is the best hair sculpt. But what I'd wish Hot Toys would do is when they release figures with rooted hair, is to give you an option. Maybe in the box, give you a separate head sculpt that has got sculpted hair on it. That way, you can get a more movie accurate look to your figure. Yes, rooted hair is nice, it's more realistic, but it is just a pain to try and sculpt, style it to how it should be from the movie. And a lot of people don't touch that. So, Hot Toys, if you're watching this video, which I doubt very much, give us a second head sculpt, please. I don't think there are any male figures that Hot Toys have released that have got rooted hair at the moment. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they're all sculpted. It's just the females. So we'll take a closer look at the face sculpts, starting with the original version. So this is from Iron Man 2. For its time, it was very good, because we didn't have anything else really to compare it to. When you stand it next to the other three, you can see how wrong it is. And it is the most expensive out of the four as well. I think these are going for, on average, on eBay anyway, £250 and upwards, which is way too much money for this figure. It's still a nice figure to have. If you're into Black Widow, then obviously, if you want to collect them all, then you've got to have it. Then we move on to the Avengers version. Huge improvement on the original. Clothing is superb as well, it fits much better. If you can see with this one, in the crutch, it hangs down a little bit. And this one, it fits perfectly, as with the other two as well. So, Hot Toys done a huge improvement with the clothing, and I think a lot of that is due to the body underneath. It's more anatomically correct, it's a shorter figure, which is what it should be because Scarlet isn't very big. They've got the proportions just about right on this one. Head sculpt, again, to me, it's not Scarlet. Maybe If I manipulate the hair around a bit more, it will give you more of a lightness. But for a lot of people, this is their favorite out of the four. Then we move on to my favorite out of the four, head sculpt wise anyway. There's more of a lightness to me of Scarlet in that face than there is, as you can see, the one next to it. That could be anybody, really. But there's more of a lightness to Scarlet in this one. But again, it's still not there yet. Hopefully on their fifth release, when the next movie comes out, they might get it right. But the clothing on this one is more cloth, whereas the others are like a plastic, a rubber. So this one should stand the test of time a lot more. Really nice clothing on this one. And this is the latest. This is my favourite clothing wise. It's mainly because it's got slightly different colours in it. It runs through it. I mean, the blue and the red. Again, though, the head sculpt, to me, it's not quite Scarlet. Now, a lot of people are saying this is just a repaint of this one. As you can see, hopefully, if it will focus, between the two, there are differences in the face. It is a slightly different sculpt from what I can see. Paint is different as well. I mean, this one, it's got more of a, you can't really see it on this camera, but it's got more like a dirty sort of wash over it. And this one's more clean cut. But again, body-wise, got it just about right. The reason I've got all the accessories out with this one is because this is a new figure. I don't do single figure videos anymore, and I just wanted to show you some of the accessories that this one comes with. But we'll go over that when I show you the figures individually. So what I'll do now is I'll put a pause in, and we'll take a look at the side view of all four together, so you can see the differences there. Okay. Here we have the side view on. As I mentioned earlier, you can see the backside on this one protrudes a hell of a lot. This is the problem they had with the Hot Toys Alice figure as well. Her backside stuck out too much. I'm really hoping Hot Toys do make some more of those. They are making the fifth and final movie of that now, Resident Evil. So hopefully Hot Toys will bring us some more of those at some point. But you can see the definite differences there between the four figures. I mean, this one is a lot slimmer. It seems slimmer than this one. I think that's mainly down to the clothing. Because this is more tight-fitting sort of rubber, it tends to make the figure look a bit thinner. It also makes it look like the breasts on this one are up a bit more, and this one they're down. And this one again, the breasts look a little bit bigger again, but that's mainly down to the clothing that she's got on. But again, I'm not sure if it's the same body underneath. I don't think it is. I think they have changed the body slightly. I could be wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong on that. I'm not an expert on that. But to me, the body on the newer version does look slightly different. More, how can I put it? More athletically lean, should I say? But that's the differences between them sidewise. I'll put another pause in. You can have a look at the back end of them as well. That'll show the back sides off a little bit more, so you can see the differences there. Okay, here we have the back view. Again, with the original, you can see that it's wider, bigger butt. I mean, Scarlet has got quite well, now she's got quite a voluptuous backside because she's just had a kid, of course. So that will make differences, but not quite like that. The other three, I think it's mainly down again to the clothing. This one looks a little bit bulkier, but again, I say it's the clothing that's doing it. I think underneath the clothing, she's got another pair of pants under there, which sort of pushes it out a little bit more. This one's a more natural sort of look, in my opinion, again, than this one. But you can see the broadness of the shoulders. This one's slightly pumped out a little bit more, which makes me think that there is a slightly different body underneath there. I think the body on these two are the same, but because of the clothing, it makes them look different. I mean, with this tight rubber on, you can see her shoulder blades underneath, which is a great touch. But yeah, there's the difference between them from the backside. So I'll do now, put a pause in, and we'll take a quick sort of look at each figure individually. Okay, we'll start off with the original release. This is just a quick sort of 360 really of the whole figure. The hair is an issue with this one. It really is messy when you take it out of the box. So a lot of hair products in that will make a difference. So I've just left it as it is. I don't want to mess around with it. Very light on accessories as well. Couple of guns, couple of hands, that's about it for this figure. But as I say, for its time, it was really nice. And it's got a very sort of thin, rubbery boots as well, whereas all the others are more hard plastic. But I think quite a few people have done some customizations on this figure. They've changed the belt on it, put the twin guns on it. They've changed this belt as well, and they've also changed the head sculpt over, and it does look a lot different actually. The wrist guards changed throughout all the figures as well. Be able to notice that when you look at the others. And the emblems on the clothing changed as well. But it's still a nice figure to have. If you're a huge Black Widow fan like me, it's a must-have really, just for nostalgia reasons really. You've got one to represent her from each film she's been in. I will get all the Black Widow releases when they come out. But it's not really Scarlet, it's just a female figure that slightly resembles Black Widow in my opinion. So that's enough of her. We'll move on to the second one. Okay, here we have the second release, which for a lot of people is the best. Not for me though. As I say, it was a huge improvement on the original. Body proportions, clothing wise, head sculpt wise, paint work. Just improved it in every aspect of the figure. Again, the hair needs to be redone. But all in all, much, much better figure. It really just depends on your preference for what the clothing looks like and which head sculpt to go for, really. But what you can do is obviously mix and match. If you like this clothing but don't like this head sculpt and you prefer head sculpt from the other figure, then maybe go on eBay, just buy the body and the clothing itself and then the head sculpt from another one and make up your own. Again, the wrist blades, wrist guards are smaller, tighter fit into the hand than the arm than they are with that one. So we'll now move on to the third release. Okay, as I said, now this is my favourite head sculpt wise. The skin is darker than what you're seeing on the camera. It's just the light from the window behind me shining on it. It's making it look quite bright, quite pale. Accessories again, really nice accessories. Again, all you get is basically different types of hands. You get different wrist guards with this one, you get the one with the blue stinger, it's the same with that one as well, and you get the pistols as well. But the hair just sort of falls a little bit more natural with this one than it does with the other three. And if you do get it just about right, it does resemble Black Widow a lot more than the other three. I've had people come around looking at my collection, and I've said to them, which of these Black Widows would you say is the best? And a majority of them have said this one. So you can't really argue with that. There are a lot of collectors out there who are perfectionists and must have everything spot on. I'm not quite like that, but it would be nice to see if they could get a decent head sculpt for this figure. Okay, so we'll move on to the final one. Okay, here we have the final Black Widow, the latest release. So this is the clothing that I prefer, so what I might do is swap the heads around at some point just to see what they look like. Yes, these are supposed to be put on with the fisted hands, but I just wanted to show them on the figure. I wanted to show you the accessories that come with this one. You've got these battens. You've also got some closed battens. You've got extra hands. But the clothing on this one is superb. A lot of people show these figures with the zips down, so they've got the cleavage out. I don't do that. I might do it for fun on a video, but generally speaking, in my details, they're all decently dressed. I love the blue piping on the clothing on this one as well. So the backside looks a little bit padded because she's got a pair of pants underneath. I suppose if you really wanted to, you could undo the clothing and take them off. Give it a more natural sort of look, but it's on there for protection more than anything really. Again, it's a nice head sculpt. So if you've got the hair just about right, it could look pretty good, this figure. But I just prefer the third release rather than this one. Just want to show you another couple of accessories that this one comes with. You've got the guns. It has two of these come with the figure. I'm not going to show her with them on, just for display purposes, really. She didn't really use them that much in the movie. But yeah, there you go. I'll put a pause in, show all four together again, and round off this video. Okay, so here we have all four back together again. So, which one should you buy? Depends on several different factors, really. Which clothing do you prefer? You know, which look of clothing? What head sculpt do you prefer? What hair do you prefer? Accessory-wise, it doesn't really need to matter because you can buy accessories on eBay and just kit each one out with whatever accessories you want, really, so that shouldn't be an issue. As I said, if you prefer this body and this head, then go on eBay, as I say, try and find someone who's selling just the body and the clothing. There are some on there, I have seen them, and then buy this head and put it on, or vice versa. For me, what would I suggest you buying? It's difficult to say. I mean, this is my favourite, but a lot of people like the Age of Ultron movie, and if you like that, you're a huge fan of that, then you have to go for this one. So me personally, this one first, this one second, this one third, and this one last. This one isn't an essential one to get. And I would say that maybe this one isn't an essential one to get either. Posability wise, they're all pretty good. This one's probably a little bit better because the clothing's not rubberized, so you could probably keep in extreme poses for a bit longer than you would with these, although I wouldn't advise people putting their figures in extreme poses and leaving them like that, because it will rip the clothing eventually. But either of these two would be the ones that I would go for. It just depends on what look you like and which of the two films you prefer. As I say, mix and match by all means. Create your own Black Widow, which is what I might do at some point. I might go on eBay and buy some bits up and make my own. But yeah, that's what I would suggest. So hopefully this video has been helpful to people out there who haven't got this figure yet and who are thinking of getting one. I will mention as well that on eBay you can buy these head sculpts with different hair on them. People have modded them out and put different types of hairstyle on. So if you want to go down that route, then go down that route. But these two are relatively inexpensive at the moment. This one is going up slightly in price. This one has shot up astronomical. I wouldn't, if you're aiming an army which would go for, don't go for this one. And it's just basically a preference, really, with these three. So that's enough of me waffling on and repeating myself over and over again. And to my next video, I'm not sure what it's going to be. Sorry, somebody was shouting upstairs to me. I've lost track of where I was now. I've got my next figure to arrive is going to be the tank, the Iron Man tank figure, which is a special edition one from San Diego Comic-Con, Sideshow exclusive. So that'll be coming. And I think the next figures after that to arrive should be my Han Solo and Chewbacca, with my Age of Ultron Hulk. I've gone for the deluxe version. I've sold my original Hulk. I just think the Age of Ultron version's more movie accurate than the other one. And I don't like my Hulk really green. And the Age of Ultron version is a slightly toned down green from the original. So that's why he's gone. I think that's the only things I've got coming at the moment through the post. So stay tuned for them. So the next video might be a collection of my special edition Iron Man figures. That could be the next one. So as always, thanks for watching. Take care and keep collecting.